will we do with the drunken sailor? What will we do with the drunken sailor? What will we do with the drunken sailor early in the morning?
Your obsession with this Moby Dick is taking its toll on the other seamen. You can't hunt whales for revenge. This is a business.
Captain Starbuck, you can't swerve me. Ain't no one gonna swerve Ahab. Not even the gods. There'll be no swervage on this ship.
I'm way more than just a sailor on this ship. I'm here to keep Ahab in check, you know, like a voice of reason. I mean, he barely listens. But still, I mean, without me, who knows how far he would have taken this mad obsession with Moby Dick.
That Starbuck, he just doesn't get me, you know? I'm here to kill Moby Dick, and he tries to be the, voice of reason, the practical man on the ship.
Should I do it? Should I kill him? I could save the rest of the crew from his mad obsession.
I'm gonna kill Moby Dick. Sometimes I think he's out to get me.
No. I won't. No.
Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey.
Fedallah, he's a nice guy, but a little bit on the sketchy side. I mean, and I'm not gonna lie, his premonitions they're freaking me out.
You're going to die, you know. We both are. You will see two hearses. I'm telling you, my friend, this is going down.
Do you see what I mean? The guy's so creepy, I don't know what to think. I always feel like he knows something I don't know. That is the last time I hire a harpooner from Craigslist.
I get it. Ahab's my master. I'm here to serve him. But once in a while, I like to give him one of my predictions, just to keep him grounded. I mean, the man's been on a boat for like 40 years. God only knows what's happened to his mind.
Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey.
Captain Ahab, Captain Ahab, did you know that the average sperm whale goes between 80 and 90 feet? And they get up to 90 tons! Did you know? Yo, Ahab, check this out! Did you know that there's over 13,000 whales hunted by Americans every year? How insane! Hey, Captain Ahab, who do you think would win that fight? A razorback whale or a mealy-mouthed porpoise? Oh, chow, please. We both know the answer to that one.
That Ishmael. Yeah, I've seen him strutting around this poop deck from time to time. He's a decent worker, but to be honest, I just don't like him. I mean, he comes around with these random whale facts. What does he know about whaling? I've been on a ship for 40 years. That's like 70% of my life. He's only been on merchant ships. All he needs to do is keep those random cetology facts himself.
Ahab, he's all right. I mean, sometimes he gets a bit overboard with the whole white whale watching bit, but he's a good guy. But what I really don't respect is that he was in his cabin for like half the voyage. I mean, how could he just abandon us out there? And anyway, I know way more about whales because I read about them in books, like this one.
I mean, thank God we don't have much of a relationship. I mean, literally, that is. Metaphorically, maybe a lot more deeper stuff going on, but I don't know. I mean, that guy is just a pretentious little f-
Way, hey, up she rises. Way, hey,
oh, that was awesome. Shame we could only do it once, though. Well, bad time for me to be getting back to the sea.
No, wait, stay with me. We've only done this once, and be a man for God's sakes.
I can't, I just can't.
You know, she's a good woman, but I hate to leave her. But I have bigger and better things to take care of. I guess you could say I have bigger fish to fry. Besides, I'm married to the sea.
He's never home. It's like we're not even married. I mean, like, seriously, he just left his wife and son behind. Who does that? I have to be, like, the only person that would marry him. I mean, he's a terrible person. He's never around. And he's got one leg. I mean, really? He's got one leg. Seriously, sometimes I just don't see the point.
But You know, sometimes I do feel guilty. I mean, I basically widowed that girl, and now my son doesn't really have a father. But then I think of my great life at sea, and then I just feel great. I feel great about myself. I mean, on the sea, 30 men at your side, I'm living the dream right now. That's just Pip. He's been a bit off, granted, you know, since the accident. He fell off the boat, nearly drowned. I mean, God knows he's a terrible worker. I mean, Stubb lost a whale because of him. But regardless, I kind of took a liking to him. Let him live in my quarters. Arrgh, quick scope, you scallywag! I'd like to consider myself a mentor to him. I mean, he's really coming along great.
I look, you look, he looks, we look, ye look, they look.
The grammar thing is getting a bit annoying, but he's a good kid.
Way, hey, that's your rises, way, hey.
I was just sitting there, mind my own business, when Ahab attacked me. I just didn't know what to do. I mean, he just came out of nowhere. So I thought to myself,
what should I do?
Should I remind him we've done this before?
Should I accept my role as a villain?
Or should I tell him I am not a role model?
Hey, Mr. Brennan.
What should I do?
You know what? I think I'm just gonna go with that villain thing.
So this is it, Moby. This was it. It was me versus Moby Dick, mano a mano. I turned to the Pequot for help, but... You know, in retrospect, probably was not the smartest idea to fight the whale. I mean, he is a whale and I'm just a man, but... You know what? I don't care! He took out my leg, and I'm a warrior, and I'll stand by this battle. Sure, he beat me, but I'd like to think I gave him a good fight. I mean, I have plenty of raw power.
I just wrecked him. He didn't stand a chance against the white whale.